Hey everybody, it's Dr. Pivler again, the board certified internal medicine doctor and functional medicine specialist. Here for another episode today about COVID-19 and zinc. All right, let's talk about some key takeaways regarding zinc. Zinc has many important physiologic functions. It has many crucial roles, including DNA repair, protein synthesis, wound healing, as well as general growth and development for children and adults. Because your body has no way to store zinc, you have to take it in on a daily basis. The recommended daily allowance for males is 11 to 15 milligrams per day, and for females, it's 8 to 11 milligrams per day. So by far, the highest content food for zinc there is oysters. Other things like lobster, crab, beef have high contents of zinc. From a plant-based source, pumpkin seeds and cashews have a high amount of zinc. Several studies have been published regarding the relationship between zinc and COVID-19. Let's go over a few of them, shall we? Okay, so the first paper we're going to talk about is a study from the Biological Trace Element Research Journal, published in 2020. What they basically found was zinc is known to enhance antiviral potential in mammalian cells. Different approaches are there in which this trace element could prove useful in fighting life-threatening infections. So basically what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to lay the groundwork that zinc is very important for the immune system, okay? Let's go to the next one. Next study comes from the British Medical Journal Nutrition, Prevention, and Health, published in 2020. It is concluded that zinc is a critical factor for antiviral immunity. There is ample evidence suggesting that zinc depletion, also prevalent in high-income nations, compromise immune functions. As zinc depletion impairs antiviral immunity, it is hypothesized to increase susceptibility for COVID-19. Next study is from the Journal of Medical Microbiology, published in 2020. What they found was after adjusting for time at which zinc was added to their protocol, an increased frequency of being discharged home by 53% and a reduced mortality or transfer to hospice who did not require ICU care by 56%. So this paper was crazy because it showed that you had a 56% chance of likely of going home from the hospital, more likely to go home than if you didn't get zinc, and you had a 53% chance of less likely of being of succumbing to COVID-19 or being transferred to a hospice, which is when we expect a patient to pass away. The next study is a review published in the International Journal of Molecular Medicine, published in 2020. They found that in vitro experiments demonstrate that zinc possesses antiviral activity through inhibition of SARS-CoV-2 RNA polymerase. Indirect evidence also indicates that zinc may decrease the activity of angiotensin converting enzyme 2, ACE2, known as the receptor for COVID-19. Zinc possesses anti-inflammatory activity by inhibiting NF-kappa-B, nuclear factor kappa-B, signaling, and modulates regulatory T cells that may limit the cytokine storm in COVID-19. Therefore, zinc may possess protective effect and prevention and adjuvant therapy of COVID-19 through reducing inflammation, improving mucociliary clearance, prevention of ventilator-induced lung injury, modulation of antiviral and antibacterial immunity. So there's kind of a lot to unpack with this study, but basically it's laying the groundwork again that zinc improves immune function. It also can reduce inflammation. A key factor in COVID-19 is the cytokine storm phenomenon that zinc, and in the previous video, like we talked about, vitamin D helps reduce inflammation to help prevent that cytokine storm from forming. And they also talk about it being able to modulate the immune system to protect against ventilation-induced lung injury. You know, when we breathe in, generally there's a negative pressure in the lungs that takes air from the ambient air into the lungs. When we put someone on a ventilator or on like BiPAP, we're basically forcing air into the lungs, and the lungs aren't used to having that kind of pressure. So that tends to cause barotrauma to the lungs or damage to the lungs. And what they're saying is maybe zinc can potentially prevent that from happening in patients who are intubated and mechanically ventilated who have COVID-19. All right, next topic is a review in the journal PLOS, Neglected Tropical Diseases in 2021. It showed that zinc is essential for human immune function and against infectious pathogens. There are well-studied beneficial effects of zinc on immune systems, including decreased susceptibility to and improved clinical outcomes for infectious pathogens, including multiple viruses. Zinc is also an anti-inflammatory and antioxidant stress agent, relevant to some severe COVID-19 disease symptoms. It has been reported that COVID-19 patients had significantly lower zinc compared to healthy individuals, and this was associated with a greater than five-fold increased likelihood of developing complications. So this paper kind of starts out saying that, yes, again, zinc is important for immune function. We know that. We've seen this. So it's also showing that people who have COVID-19 have significantly lower zinc than people who are healthy. Okay, next study, a multi-center cohort study. This study is still actually in the publication phase. It's yet to be peer-reviewed or published. It's in the pre-published phase. This was a multi-center cohort study conducted with 3,400 patients hospitalized with PCR positive SARS-CoV-2 or COVID-19 infection admitted to four different New York City hospitals between March 10th and May 20th, 2020. The zinc ionophore used in the study was hydroxychloroquine. Zinc with an ionophore was associated with an increased rate of discharge home and a 24% reduced risk of in-hospital mortality among COVID-19 patients, while neither zinc alone nor an ionophore alone reduced mortality. So this particular paper happened to be using zinc in combination with another medication, in this case hydroxychloroquine, and it showed that zinc alone, in this particular paper, zinc alone did not reduce mortality, but zinc with the ionophore did reduce mortality by 24%. Neither the ionophore by itself or zinc by itself in this particular paper did not reduce mortality. So just to be clear on that one. A study published in the journal Frontiers in Immunology in 2020. As zinc is essential to preserve natural tissue barriers such as respiratory epithelium, the skin of your respiratory tract, preventing pathogen entry, bugs getting inside of you, for a balanced function of immune system and redox system, zinc deficiency can probably be added to the factors predisposing to infection and detrimental progression of COVID-19. Finally, due to its direct antiviral properties, it can be assumed that zinc administration is beneficial for most of the population, especially for those with suboptimal zinc status. Okay, next paper. A study published in the journal Medical Hypotheses in 2020. Administration of zinc supplement has a potential to enhance antiviral immunity, both innate and humoral, and to restore depleted immune cell function or improve normal immune cell function, in particular in immunocompromised or elderly patients. Zinc may also act in a synergistic manner when co-administered with the standard antiviral therapy, as was demonstrated in patients with hepatitis C, HIV, and SARS-CoV-1. Therefore, it may be hypothesized that zinc supplementation may be a potential benefit in prophylaxis and treatment of COVID-19. A study from the International Journal of Infectious Disease in 2020. Among the COVID-19 patients, 54% were found to be zinc deficient. These patients were found to have a higher rate of complications, acute respiratory stress syndrome, ARDS, a terrible complication of any really pneumonia or viral lung infection. 18.5% of people who had zinc deficiency developed ARDS. If you had no zinc deficiency, 0% of people developed ARDS. Required corticosteroid therapy, prolonged hospital stay, and increased mortality. The increased mortality was 18.5% with people who were zinc deficient and 0% for people who were zinc non-deficient. The odds ratio for developing complications was 5.54 for zinc deficient COVID patients. What that means basically is that you're 5.5 times more likely to develop complications if you're zinc deficient and having COVID versus not being zinc deficient. This study data clearly showed that a significant number of COVID-19 patients were zinc deficient. These zinc deficient patients developed more complications, and the deficiency was associated with prolonged hospital stay and increased mortality. Let's just get this straight. If you are zinc deficient, hospitalized for COVID-19, you have a 5.5 times more likely chance of having a complication of COVID-19. Those complications include ARDS, that really terrible lung condition that can develop with severe pneumonias and sepsis and things like that, and mortality. So we want to make sure that we are not zinc deficient. Although we don't check zinc levels in the hospital, mostly because it takes just too long for the tests to come back, zinc deficiency has been shown to be associated with several different conditions, including obesity and diabetes. And those two particular conditions happen to be some of the highest chances of being hospitalized and having a bad outcome from COVID-19. So if you have diabetes or if you are obese, you need to make sure it's a priority for you to have your levels checked and to be taking extra supplemental zinc. A high percentage of the patients that I've admitted to the hospital personally have these conditions. So therefore, it's very easy to assume that zinc deficiency could be a problem for those particular patients. And because we know this is a known factor, we do supplement people in the hospital with zinc. If someone comes to the hospital with COVID-19, I'll go ahead and empirically give them 50 milligrams of zinc 3 times per day with meals. It is important to take it with meals because it can make you nauseous, so especially at a higher dose like that. So what are the clinical takeaways regarding COVID-19 and zinc? Zinc is essential for human immune function and for activity against certain pathogens, including viruses. Zinc deficiency will impair antiviral immunity. It's also hypothesized to increase your susceptibility to COVID-19. Zinc possesses anti-inflammatory activity, which may limit the cytokine storm seen in COVID-19. Low zinc levels have been found to be higher in patients with COVID-19 that are hospitalized than those who are not. And it's been shown to have a 5 times greater risk for having complications of COVID-19 than people who are not deficient in zinc. Complications seen in patients who are zinc deficient are the fact that they are prolonged hospital stays, or they're in the hospital for longer periods of time, and they have a higher chance of mortality or a chance of dying. Remember, there's no way to store zinc in your body, so you have to have a daily intake of this mineral. The recommended daily allowance for zinc is 11 to 15 milligrams per male and 8 to 11 milligrams per female. And remember, the highest sources of zinc are in oysters, other seafood, beef, and then for plant-based, it would be pumpkin seeds and cashews. Just by liking this video, your zinc levels will go up. Okay, that's actually not true. But if you do like it, please like it. And if you'd like to hear more content like this, please do subscribe. Until next time, Dr. Peebler out.